a rep. I said, what's that on your hand? He said, that's where I blocked the punch from Errol. So think about this. It went through Errol's glove, Errol's mitt.
And these 16-ounce gloves, this, you know,
and
sparring.
It went through Rob's gloves and Rob's hand wraps. And it was a bruise on the back of his hand. That's for real. He went, boom, Rob blocked the punch. And so, and boom, that's how he punched, yeah.
Did you ever get a black and blue mark from Spence?
Man, well, my, sometimes it hit me in my arm, my elbow may be messed up or something, but you don't know.
What's your reaction to Andre Ward having Errol Spence number 8 on his pound-for-pound list?
It's okay. I mean, it's, I love Andre Ward for what he does, did, and who he is as an individual. So it's his own personal prerogative. Mm-hmm. I mean, look at how they people had him down. They wouldn't give him his own merit for even when he beat Kovalev the first time, second time, all the way up. So, I mean, it's okay. I mean, I'm okay with that.
Is Mikey Garcia's silence, because he was very vocal prior to the fight, is Mikey Garcia's silence just as satisfying as beating him March 16th?
I mean, it's okay. I mean, the fight is over, nothing to say. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I think that silenced everybody in boxing in a sense. Mm-hmm. Then other people talking about the size. Which, like I said before, all those other guys y'all want Errol to fight are the same size, fought the same weight division. So it's like, Mikey was very intelligent, and look, Mikey can beat a lot of other guys, just not that one particular guy. And that's all it was.
Coach, if you had your choice, what 3 fights would you want for Errol? Out of everybody in the world, 1, 2, 3.
I told you I don't do that. Man.
No, if you wanted to. Okay, I'll give you 5 names, if you could list them in any order. You have Crawford, Porter,
Danny Garcia,
Pacquiao and Thurman.
Okay, I want the guys for him to fight that he wants to fight.
Okay.
That Al wants him to fight.
Okay.
That's it.
All that.
In that order.
Are you familiar with Crawford? Do you know him well? Have you studied him?
You know what? I met him before, and I like him. I think he's a pretty cool cat. He's always kind of cracking jokes.
Yes, he is.
Me and Errol.
Yeah.
He's a pretty present guy, man.
You saw that video, I'm sure, where he walks up to him, and they were going back and forth.
Yeah, y'all saw that. But
that was in Oklahoma, I think.
Yeah, right. But there's been other times where we were in Vegas at the Canelo Triple G too. And he came up to us, cracking jokes.
What was he saying?
He was saying something to Errol, and then Errol said, you see my trainer right here, he's ready. And I stood up, he's old, man. You know, it's not like we're playing with it. Remember they challenged, like, his trainer against his trainer, whatever.
I was seeing joking, but that time in Oklahoma, Terrence basically said, oh, you know, I got my trainer versus your trainer, and Errol, you know, spoke
highly. That's what we kind of joking about.
Right. But obviously that is in fun and joke, but what does it mean to you as a trainer, many times overlooked, to know that your champion that you helped build up and Errol Spence speaks so highly and in such a high regard of you? What does that mean to you?
That means a lot, man. But he knows I still work out. He knows I still run. I ran this morning 3 miles. With the bike 3 miles, so I'm still working out. I'm still working. I still try to stay in shape to be able to keep up with them, not outside the ring, but in the ring. Him and Jamel, those guys push me, so I got to be in shape for that, man. Plus, I want to look fit and decent. I'm just 47. I don't want to look like, you know, whatever.
Kell
so
Brook.
I do my best to be in shape. What's up with Kell Brook?
Kell Brook trains Crawford for wins.
Hey, man, I'm going for the American, man. Come on, yeah, I got it. If he's from the UK, I'm going for the Team USA. All the time.
What problems does Kell Brook present to Terrence Crawford?
I mean, you know what, though? I think that Terrence Crawford is so athletic that's his greatest strength is his athleticism and his ability to find shots, right? I saw, like, when he caught the guy with the punch, Amir Khan, in the first round. Uh-huh. But it was like, but that was all I saw, the other fight. I didn't watch it all. I don't watch a lot of boxing. I say that all the time. People don't believe me. But I think that his athleticism, Kell Brook may try to use his mass, he should, but man, this guy moves around on you like that. I can't see him being able to keep up with him anyway. But I'm going for Team USA anyway. Just, you know.
So Eddie Hearn told us yesterday, what did he say? How did he say it? He said that Spence needs to give Mikey a hug. Because he said that the both of them put together 47,000 asses in seats.
47. Oh, yeah, that's good. But realistically, it was more than 47 because you didn't count the suites.
Correct.
They had the suites where probably like another 2,000 to 4,000 people in the suites.
So Mikey Spence did 300,000 pay-per-view, Conor Crawford 100,000. So if Crawford Spence fight, is that pay-per-view or is that Fox?
Would have to be pay-per-view just because of the money that they would have to pay these guys. But at the same time, I'm along with Errol on the fact that I think it should be promoted more. I mean, I'm not a promoter, right? But I promoted boxing before. And what I would say is, like, it's the build-up, right?
It's
the build-up. It's the build-up. It's the intrigue, the getting the people involved in it, right? Just like everything else, man, just like life. It's the build-up, the build-up. We started promoting that fight, Mikey and Al, for five weeks, right? I mean, that's what you mean. That's what All Access for them, 24/7, that's what that was all about. So I think that I'm not a promoter. I'm not telling Bob Arum how to do it. He's very successful at what he does. But I did an interview with Kevin Ioli, right? He asked me about Terrence Crawford. I told him about Terrence Crawford, how great a fighter he is, how much I like him. And I said, man, when is that fight? He said, man, it's Saturday. I was like, what? He said, it was Saturday. So I didn't even know that when they were fighting.
Earl said the same thing.
I'm a boxing guy in boxing with a guy the same way as that guy. If I don't know, it's an issue. So that's all I'm saying. I mean, you know, how can the fan who doesn't watch boxing, you want to get the guy who doesn't watch boxing? That's how you become a superstar.
I got boxing fans. And people that, colleagues, I can say, in the business, that didn't even know how to order the pay-per-view. They were confused whether it was on through the channel, through the app, through the cable provider. So I feel like you spoke on, a promotion is definitely a huge part in that, building these fights up.
I just think that, and I'm when it comes to that, like, on this level, I'm an idiot to that, and I admit that, but at the same time, I would want people to, social media is not the way to, only way to promote a fight. Like, I saw it on Facebook, Instagram, come on, man. What are you talking about? Like, that's it? You gotta get the people who are not following these guys on that.
Do you think it's intentional, or Lomachenko is just a better fighter than Crawford?
You said that I didn't, so don't ask me a question that you know the answer.
Well,
I'm coming at you now.
Terrence Crawford is the best fighter in the world. Right, Terrence Crawford,
he's earned it, 140.
Yes.
What you said was,
Do you think it's intentional, or Lomachenko is just a better fighter?
What do you think it is?
I think it's intentional.
What if it being a better fighter doing? The one thing Errol said, which is true, is that if I'm fighting, they didn't mention Keith Thurman, Sean Porter, Danny Garcia, Hula, Floyd Mayweather, Boogie, they didn't mention anybody, right? They just mentioned Mike Garcia and Errol Spence. Mm-hmm. So, there we go.
So, Coach, I have Errol Spence as number one pound for pound. Yeah. Who do you have?
Yeah,
I have Errol one.
Okay.
Yeah.
People don't give him enough credit. Who do you have as number two right now in the world?
Hey, man, you know what I always say? Number one never cares about number two.
Wow.
And this is reality. So if I'm the guy who's in front, I can't care about what the other people behind me talk about, right? So everybody's going to talk about you. Everybody's going to say whatever. And like they say, when the lead dog is leading, the view never changes. So all I see is that. The view never changed for everybody else behind me. All he's looking at is what?
Yeah.
All right, that's what I'm saying. So we're in the sled of dogs. That's all I'm looking at. So that's all.
Your reaction? I don't know if you saw it, but I know you might have heard it. It's been a meme. Bob Arum basically telling people to boycott PBC.
That was crazy because it's boxing.
Mm-hmm.
So. But you know, hey, man, you know how people are, they're hard-headed. What you tell them not to do is what they generally will actually probably do. Just like kids, I mean, so, you know, who knows me? Who knows me? I just think that it's a team effort. It's like you get them hyped on Terrence Crawford, and they mention Errol Spence, they're going to be thinking about Errol Spence next. So they get, I mean, you know, you got to fight. So see, but the reality, let's go back to Lomachenko.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He is a phenomenal fighter.
But he's...
He's just not marketable.
Mm-hmm.
He's not... He's amazing. When is he fighting?
He don't speak English.
When is he fighting?
He just fought...
No, he did?
Yeah, he did. He just fought, what, a week and a
half? April 14, I think.
Oh, he did. Sure did. April 12 or something like that. He sure did. April 12. Here in L.A., in my hometown. Yeah, he fought in L.A.
He fought at the Staples Center.
He sure did. Because Crawford fought the following week.
For real?
Yes. The 12th was a Friday at the Staples Center.
Yeah.
This is a meme. I didn't know he fought. Are you
really
serious?
Yeah.
Wow.
I just asked you, when was he fighting?
Uh-huh.
That's it.
He should be fighting in September, October, probably.
But, I like him as a fighter. I think Terrence Crawford's a phenomenal fighter, and also Lomachenko's a phenomenal fighter. I mean, I just think you're trying to push, you know, with all of the Russian stuff involved, I guess America's not buying it.
How much better is Terrence Crawford than Lomo? Would you say if Terrence Crawford?
Well,
a 10,
I don't know. I can't say that. I just have to say that.
Hold on.
You would have to put them in the ring together and see.
That would never happen.
I'm just saying. I mean, that's how you know how good one guy is out of the other. I don't know. I mean, I have no idea. I think that they're both amazing, super athletic. Lomachenko, he does all the angles. He's amazing. Crawford is so. Like I say he's like he finds those shots.
He finds holes. I don't know how he does it. Yeah.
I mean, you know, and that's what makes you great.
And you don't waste them either. You don't waste his punches.
I mean, you know, now, but, and that's what I'm talking about. So see, and that he looks great, but I don't know. I don't know Lomachenko for. I like him. Mm-hmm. I think he's cool. I saw him one at the fight with Kovalev and Ward too. Yeah.
I was there. I interviewed him that day. I know we're done, but that interview you did with on Dante's Boxing Nation, I swear before God, I listened.